Hello and welcome back. Last time I left you with the main body of your end brush in your hand, unassembled. Now we will start by assembling it back. Okay. Place the nozzle back in. Screw the head cap in a clockwise motion. Don't over tighten it, you don't want to damage your nozzle, just make sure you screw it until you feel resistance, somewhat of a resistance, don't overdo it. Now, crown cap, again, screw it in a clockwise motion, don't overdo it. And finally, the head cap, the needle cap. Okay, now we'll put the trigger back in. You can see the trigger has a dent. This dent should be facing the rearward part of your airbrush, because as you pull it, it forms this angle, and this comes straight over the circular body of the airbrush. So, align the trigger pin with the trigger body. There's a hole inside for the air to come. The air comes through this hole. So just make sure the pin goes inside. If you want to make sure the trigger is in, just push it. See, it comes back. And you can also see the air gauge coming out. Now the needle guide. Make sure that the head is tilting faceward. Otherwise, you won't be able to put it in. See? Now this is wrong. This don't come in very easily. Just tilt it. This actually comes in the back of the trigger, so just tilt it inside. Replaced spring. Now this part that I'm screwing in right now is used to determine how soft or hard your trigger is, so just adjusting it to your liking. This is the most tightened position, and the trigger is the hardest. So just find what's good for you. Now we place back the needle. This is a bit tricky part. You don't want to get the needle tip bent or broken. So what I do is I place a finger and I use it to align the needle in. Push the needle till you have no more give. Do it gently again. Don't want to break the needle. And finally, the needle cog, the handle, and you're done.